A viewer asked me if we can create these After Effects style kinetic text animations in Resolve, and he said he needs them for shorts and reels. Say no more. Let's build it in the simplest way possible. Start by dropping a Fusion composition into your timeline and jump into Fusion. Grab a background node and connect it to the media out. Then add a text plus node and connect it to the background. Type just one letter and pick a rough font. This really sells the effect. Now, technically, we could build everything in the text node, but to keep things simple, let's add a soft glow node and a transform node after the text. In the soft glow, set blend to around 0.5, glow size to 40, and gain to 0 for now. Alright, start with the text plus node, go to frame 0 under the layout tab, set size to 0.8, and add a keyframe. Jump to frame 40 and bring it back to 1. This gives a soft breathing motion at the start. Now go to frame 75 and shrink the size to around 0.5. Next, we want our text to heat up for an incoming impact. Maybe a slap, maybe a kick. So add frame 25 under the shading tab, add keyframes on green and blue channel, and also on X softness. Now jump to frame 40, reduce green and blue to 0 for a red hot effect, and tweak X softness slightly. Perfect. The text node is done. Now the soft glow node. Add frame 0, make sure the gain is 0, and add a keyframe. Frame 35, raise it a little to 0.5. Add frame 40, set gain to 2, and add frame 75, set it to 3.5. That's our glow buildup. Next, the explosion motion. Select the transform node, add frame 40, add a keyframe on center, then move to frame 55 and tweak the center X and Y to set the path of the letter. Jump to frame 75 and move it a little further in the same direction. Let's preview it. Basic motion right. Let's give it the drama it deserves. With transform node selected, open the spline editor, enable show only selected tool, check center, click zoom to fit. I will leave the first keyframe. Then select the second and third keyframes and press S to smooth their curves. You can tweak the handles for more dramatic motion. Totally up to you. While still on transform, at frame 40, add keyframes on aspect and angle. At frame 75, set aspect to 0.8 and pick any angle. Maybe 300 for this letter. Almost done. But wait, it's just one letter. Do we have to redo all this for 5 more letters? No. Select and copy these 3 nodes. Paste them into your workspace 5 times and connect them into your main pipeline. Before typing new letters, let's batch rename your text nodes. Trust me, it will save you headaches later. Alright, select merge one and position the first letter using center X. Keep spaces even. You can do 8 or 10 letters too. Just paste more nodes as needed. Now type the text letters one by one. You can always change them later. Let's preview. All letters move the same way, not what we want. Here's a simple fix. Select the second transform node, grab the middle keyframe in the viewer, and adjust the path. Then grab the final keyframe and place it slightly after the middle keyframe. Repeat this for all remaining letters. The beauty of this tweak is, your playhead doesn't have to be on the same keyframe you are adjusting. It won't mess with your existing keyframes. Just make sure each letter follows its own random path after the explosion. Let's check how it looks. Pretty good. Except one thing. They all have the same rotation. Little details like this matter a lot. Now go to frame 75, select the second transform node and give it a little different rotation angle. Let's say minus 150 for a clockwise spin. For the next letter, I will set it to 100. The one after that, minus 50. The fifth letter, 250, and the final one, let's make it minus 400. Let's play it back. Looks good, but we still need the letters to fade out at the end. So select X1, jump to frame 65, and in the shading tab, add a keyframe on opacity. Then go to frame 75 and bring the opacity all the way down to 0. And now our first letters fades out. All right, take it easy. You don't have to redo all this keyframing for the next 5 letters. This little hack will save you hours. Select Text 2 under Shading, right-click Opacity, Connect to Text 1, Opacity 1. And now, Text 2 follows the opacity of Text 1. Do the same for the remaining letters. And you are done in just a minute. Let's play it one last time. Looks good. If you want me to turn this into a complete macro preset, let me know in the comments. And if you learned something today, hit like and subscribe.